Hello, hello, hello. Today is Saturday, January 4, 2025. Problem 220. It is our first problem in the new year, and I promised that it would be very easy. Yes, definitely a high school problem. When I was in high school, I would have had no problems with this problem. The reason why Keith and Organ and I decided to start with a very, very simple problem is that all three of us were disappointed with the results of problems of the last few months. Problems for which the answers could clearly be found in my lectures. In some cases, there were only four or five correct solutions. And that is discouraging for all three of us. This problem is close to trivial. And if I don't get at least 12 correct solutions, then Keith and Organ and I have decided that this will be the only problem in 2025. End of story. Here we go. A cube is soldered together from identical pieces of wire, each of resistance R, lowercase r. It is connected to a circuit at the corners lying on the opposite diagonal ends. See the figure. So this cube is in a circuit. So current either goes in this direction or it goes in that direction, depending upon, of course, upon the potential difference. What is the equivalent resistance? And if you forgot what the meaning of equivalent resistance is, well, watch my 802 lectures. In all cases of problems last year, with a few exceptions, you could always find the answers in my lectures. And many of you, or most of you, often didn't want to put in the effort to search for my lectures and thereby perhaps brush up on their physics or in some cases learn even some new physics. Have a great year. And even if the three of us decide that this is going to be our last problem this year, you will always be my friends. That's always a given. I would like to add that you people probably have no idea how much time Keith, Norman, and Orion and I spent on these problems. Selecting the problems and modifying them can take me sometimes 2 days. And even after 2 days, I may still modify it. And then I ask Keith and Organ for their opinion, and then we finally agree at the final problem. And then they do the solutions, which is always very nice. It saves me a lot of time. So now you may understand why we feel very disappointed. We spent so much time on these problems, and we often send emails back and forth to each other and finally decide to not even do that problem. We are very disappointed that most of you are not willing to to spend some time on it. Going back to my lectures, where in all cases, with few exceptions, the answers are always there. So we sort of feel if you're not willing to put in the efforts that we expect from you, then maybe we should just stop for 1 year. Only one problem in 2025. And then we'll see you again in 2026.